Shalom, this is your brother Yahweh coming to give another lesson. And this lesson will be entitled, Reprobate Israelites, You've Been Rejected from the Lord. Salakia. That's another video that I'm going to make later. This video will be Satanic Rituals for Fame and Fortune Will Get You Destroyed. Alright, and I came across a video with Richard Pryor, which I'm going to play in a little bit. Alright. basically, you know, how the industry of America, Babylon the Great, portrays itself to be, you know, the most fun nation of riches, you know, through darkness and wickedness, witchcraft and warlocks, all right, rituals of sacrificing and worshiping false idols and false gods in order to pertain a fortune on this side of life, man. You have to do dark things and worship the likeness of Satan, okay? Which is the wicked of the earth, and the wicked and the counterpart of the flesh of this earth. You know, the devil will be Esau Edom, which is the so-called white nation, Esau Edom, all right? Which is the Bible speaks of him being the wicked. Okay, he's the one who rules the earth. That nation stands on ruling the whole entire earth, man. It's in their power and their laws and how they do things of how this world runs, man, which is completely corruption, confusion, all right, and all out time murder, because this is all they've done. Steal, kill, rob, conquer, and pillage. Rape, robbed, and murder. They stole everything. This is the people, man, who have set up these high statues of wickedness. All right, you can go into the family of the Rockefeller, the Rothschilds, the Gates family, and so on and so on. But this is what I'm going to get into with the scriptures. Well, willing. Let's give all praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Gwadash. All right, what's the true Heavenly Father's name? He who exists, he who is, the Heavenly Father's name, and by Hashem is the end of the name of Yahweh Shai, he our deliverer. Okay? That is the Son's name, which the world today ignorantly calls God and Jesus Christ, which is not his name. Alright? Let's give all double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, okay, who have the 100% truth, who we learn this truth from through the power of spirit of Yahweh Shai, and citation to the elder of Michael Chazak, who I teach under here in Greenville, South Carolina, the cap of men of Israel, and shalom to you, Aqua and Aqua, you being a woman who believes and watch our videos and tend to our testimonies through the power of spirit, I should be able to shout at the gospel, all right, that has been taught, all right, in sincerity and truth, and keeping the commandments to the best of our ability in these times of latter days. I'd like to say shalom. Without further ado, I'm going to start the video, and then I'm going to get into the scriptures, and Lord's willing, this video will be short, all right.
Bishop, can I ask you a serious question? About young comedians.
About young girls, ask me about that. You don't like young girls? Say comedians. You don't like young girls on television.
Smile if I don't like young girls. No, I like young girls.
Yeah, I fuck them. I ain't no good, I ain't trying to be no good.
I may end up running off with you myself, you know.
That's what Steven says.
Steven Spielberg?
Yeah.
Yeah. He's a good director, isn't he?
Yeah.
Steven Spielberg is a pedophile.
Can you tell us a secret about Steven Spielberg? He eats babies. Whole babies.
Daughter who's a really good-looking chick. Well, you may be able to change her life and improve your financial status. Because Prince Andrew is looking for a new girlfriend. Just drop a nude photo of your little nymphette in a self-addressed stamp envelope and mail to Royal Affair, Buckingham Palace.
Fisher, can I ask you a serious...
All right, there you saw it, man. It's not just Richard Pryor, man. It's a whole lot of them. It's a whole lot of them, man. They done this ritual, man. Sleeping with little girls and babies. Tossing them in fires and stuff like that. Eating them. Okay? They do this shit. Excuse me for my voice. I have a runny nose, so I'm talking with a little difference. But I was ready for all the sinuses and all the pollen and all that. But yeah, man. Back to the subject at hand, man. This is what goes on. The Hollywood pedoverse, pedoveries, pedophiles, man. And they're trying to, you know, sub that word out so, you know, the video could be, you know, staying on the TikTok. But we see these things, man. We know these things. The man... The men of the Lord, we see these things, we know these things, and we're going to call these things out. Okay? That has been part of being a watchman, of being righteous, man. And condemning the wicked for the whatever they're doing. Right in front of our faces, man. And this is time for our people to wake up out of that. Which is our people will be the Israelites the Bible speaks of. The Hebrew Israelites the Bible speaks of. Which consists of the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians. All right? You are the true Hebrew Israelites according to Deuteronomy 28. All right? We fit the curses of that, of the scriptures. Okay? We fit those curses detail upon detail. Okay? And I'm going to go ahead and grab scripture. And I'm going to start with, Mark. Start with Mark 8:35. And it says, for whosoever, this is Mark chapter 8, verse 35, 36, and 37. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it. But whosoever shall lose his life for my sake and the gospels, what pertaining to what? His word, his commandments. And obedience to his word and commandments. The same shall save it. You see that? His life. Only thing that's going to save your life is coming back to the law, statutes, and commandments. Coming back to your true power, Yahweh Shabbat Shah. Okay? Coming back to the ordinance of your heritage, which has been bestowed upon you to be righteous upon all nations. Okay? In verse 36, for what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? You see that? And you see, and you know the contracts they do to get the fortune and the fame in Hollywood, Bollywood, whatever. Backwood rapist ritual that they have set up to gain these things and to gain power and control. You have to bow to the mouth of it, man. You have to bow to their gods. You have to get it and do the wicked rituals, okay? Man with man, woman with woman, all right? Having sex with beasts and animals, which is prohibited from you in Leviticus. We're not supposed to do those things of which the nations of the, you know, the other nations are doing, okay? We're not to. We're to be separate from those. But what are people to have done? Our people has pertained into lust for things that are contrary to the scriptures, man. That are contrary to the law, statutes, commandments the Lord has set up for us as a nation of the Hebrew Israelites. Okay? And this is why we're being cursed. This is why we're at a lower state. Because our people has forsaken the Lord. They have turned away from his laws. They have turned away from his teachings and his obedience. And, not being obedient and being proud and malicious, learning to do wicked, practicing wicked, and inventing ways to be wicked, such as those who are wicked, which is the other nations that are created to be just wicked. All right. But, you know, in verse 37, or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? And the only thing that's going to be is the things of this world. Money, fame, women, all that. Okay? This is a thing that you just saw in that video with Richard Pryor. Okay? You saw these things. Let's see if they got any more. I don't think they got any more like that. But I'm trying to see if I can find something else.
Who taught you to hate the texture of your hair? Who taught you to hate the color of your skin to such extent that you bleach to get like the white man?
Yeah, we know he sold out too. All right, but you know, back to the scriptures, man. Basically, you know, these rituals are very serious. We can go to Deuteronomy 22. We get that. Excuse me, my nose keep running. Chapter 22, verse 25. It says, but if a man find a betrothed damsel. Yeah, let me see if I get that word. Betrothed a damsel. Let me get that. All right, we're going to go to Deuteronomy, chapter 22, 25. Let everything be edified. All right, what's a damsel? Let's get that. There we go. Okay, damsel, girl, female servant, girl, damsel, little girl, of young woman, marriageable young woman, concubine, prostitute, maid, female, attendant, female servant. You see that? Maid, young woman. And so, what we see in that video, they talk about young children, young women. See that? And this is another damn ritual.
This we all know Quincy Jones was door eyes and all.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Was in the alphabet group. All those people were there.
You can't touch this.
Look at that. Look at that. You
can't touch this. You can't touch this.
Yeah, shit,
it's both a lot of hard work.
We spent a lot of time.
ET and Carla at the same time.
Laying down on the ground at midnight.
Yeah, sleeping.
See that sick ass shit? Yeah, this is the things y'all want. When y'all want to get rich, this is things y'all want to do. Get molested, touch on little women, touch on little boys. This is the things that you have to face when you go do these rituals, man. To get humiliated. To be tore the fuck down. To have to feel as though you have no power, nobody to help you, man. Yet, this is why you see these celebrities commit crimes. They commit crimes like regular people. They more miserable than a regular average citizen because of the things they have done, bro. The things they have done and what they've done to even make it into that, to that level, bro. So we know what damsel be. So now we're going to read the scripture. In Deuteronomy chapter 22 and verse 25 says, but if a man find a betrothed damsel in the field, a young woman in the field, and a man forced her, okay, rape, you know, and lie with her, take her. Then the man only that lay with her shall die. You see that? And all these people who's doing it, who's raping your little women, they're going to die. The Lord going to kill them. They're going to get judged. In verse 26. But unto the damsel, thou shalt do nothing. Okay, she's going to live. There is in the damsel no sin worthy of death. Because she what? Was innocent. She didn't know what was going on. She was just took it and was forced upon. Alright? By that man who forced her. Like these celebrities forcing these little children, these little boys. For what? For their likeness of doing their rituals to gain more money, to gain more fame, to be more known, and to just fucking do it. Because they feel entitled. It's their pride. It's their way of honoring their god, Molech, and Baal, man. For as when a man resists against his neighbor, his resent against his neighbor, and slayeth him, even so is this matter. I'm going to read that again. But unto the damsel thou shalt do nothing. There is in the damsel no sin worthy of death. For as when a man resenteth against his neighbor, and slayeth him, even so is this matter. Verse 27, for he found her in the field, and the betrothed damsel cried, and there was none to save her. And when they bring these people out to those woods, when they put them on that table and burn them to Molech and Baal, that's what they doing. Ain't nobody out there to save them. All these little children, immigrants, they go missing and all that. Oh, yeah. That's what they doing. It's right in front of our faces. Right in front of our faces. And the Lord sent his prophets out to warn you about these things, man. And what our people not doing. They're not listening. They're chasing after these things. They want to be rich. They want to be the famous, the most best rapper, the best singer, the best dancer. They want to be everything Esau has created this so-called black culture to be based upon. Entertainment. All right. I'm going to get some more scriptures, man. Let's go to Leviticus 18 and 21. It says, and thou shalt not let any of thy seed pass through the fire to Molech. What is that? Babies. All right. Neither shall thou profane the name of thy power. I am the Lord Yahweh. All right. Go back to what? Sacrifices. Sacrifices these wicked celebrities are doing. Okay. Well, they sacrifice their mothers, their kids, you know. Their kids die out of nowhere. Have the heart attacks. They ain't heart attacks, man. They sacrifice their kids. That's why when they sign them contracts, when Big Bill signed that contract, remember, it shook his head. He said, what? They got another nigga gone. You see that? Because they already know. They already know. And we see Big Bill at Diddy's party with his butt sticking out of his pool. So we already know he's been touched. Just as Usher has been touched and many others has been touched by that man who believes in that god of Molech because he's getting riches. Because he has control over police departments. They work for him. They are too with the things that he do because he pays them to ignore his behavior. And many other celebrities that are gatekeepers, man, like Will Smith. Who molested his kids. Okay. Let's get Deuteronomy 12 and 30. Verse 30. And we read all the way down to 32. It says, take heed to thyself that thou be not snared by following them. After that, they be destroyed from before thee. And that thou inquire not after their gods. Say, how did these nations serve their gods? Even so will I do likewise. Thou shalt not do so unto the Lord thy power. For every abomination to the Lord which he hateth, have they done unto their gods.
for even their sons and their daughters have been burnt in fire to their gods. Going back to what I just said. In verse 32. What they subvert soever I command you observe to do it. This is the Lord speaking. Yahweh Shabbat Shah. Thou shalt not add thereunto, nor diminish from it. Which means when the law stands, it stands on what it says. Man. The word stands on what the word says. There's no added to it. There's no, well, I can do this a little bit. The Lord said, you do it, what he tell you to do, and what he tell you not to do, that's what you don't do. Simple as that. Simple as that. It's a lock here. All right. Be at Mark 8. This is Mark 8:35-37. It says, for whosoever will save his life shall lose it. I think I read this already. Yeah, I did. So Salaki on that. Salaki. Let's see. Yeah, I think that might be all I have on that. But I am going to grab Isaiah 13. Isaiah 13:11. And this is talking about, you know, the 2/3 of Israel, man, who rebelled against the Lord, who continued to ignore the instructions of the prophets that he has sent toward our people. So-called blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans, man, to turn and repent from their sins, man, to repent from the ways of this world, to come back to the law, statutes, commandments. We tell them, man, so that they may be saved with the second coming of the Lord, when he comes with his angels to destroy this place, man. Babylon the Great and the rest of the world that has great wrath coming towards them for their iniquities and sins, man. Only way you're going to be saved out of the most terrifying power there is when you come into you come back to the law, statutes, commandments, man, being a Hebrew Israelite. Okay? But those who don't want to come back to the Lord, you're going to perish. And verse 11 explains that. It says, and I will punish the world for their evil and the wicked for their iniquity. And I will cause the arrogance of the proud to cease. Yeah, look at it. The arrogance explains all these people who don't want to pay attention, don't want to accept that they're Hebrew Israelites, or they're Hebrew Israelites, all right, our people. They want to be simple. They love mirth. They just want to continue to live this world and gain from it. Being a slave. Not knowing that there are the most precious things to the Lord. And if we come back to the power, we'll have everything and more than what they can even imagine. But they have to go through the fire, the 2/3 of Israel, which rebelled against the word, which basically, you know, just said, I don't need the Lord. That could be their own Lord. And this is the mindset of a wicked. All right, they have became wicked, man, by following the customs of the world, following the philosophies and the religions of this world, man, practicing rituals and all these things, becoming as the heathens, becoming as the wicked. Our people has been so docile to the truth They have been so docile through the lies and philosophy of this world, Salakia, that I meant to say. They have been docile to the lies and philosophy of this world, that they, the Lord has made them reprobates, because when they came into, they have read into the truth, they denied the truth of the Heavenly Father, man. They have came against and rebelled and debated against the truth, man. So the Lord has got them lost, and they want to be destroyed with the heathens, with the wicked, for their iniquities and arrogance and proud of the seas. It says, and will lay low the haughtiness of the terrible. When the Lord's not playing, man, the Lord's going to come with full strength, man. Them chariots going to blast with that purest laser beam heat, man, that's going to evaporate everything with no trace. No matter how strong the iron or the steel, it doesn't matter. It's going to disappear, man. So, you know, that's all I have on that. I hope everything was edifying. And with that, I'm going to say shalom.